Every day, Midianite gangs pounce on one farm after the next. Are you ready? With respect, sir, God seems a long way away now that my people suffer so much. We are desperate for help. But all we have is old stories of how God saved his people many years ago. And what good are they?
You rule by fear.
Your God has ceased to exist.
Scare the people into idol worship.
He's dead.
You bind them up with your false little gods.
Baal rules, and Asherah with him.
Helping me make up my mind. Thank you, Father.
Thank God.
I am with you now and always. I will never, ever leave you. I am with you.
For years, the Hebrew people have suffered attacks by their neighboring countries. Small armed gangs of horsemen pounce on one farm after the next, plundering everything, whatever they can take. In desperation, the Hebrew people have called out to their God for help. And then one day, an angel appears to a man called Gideon. The angel tells him that he, Gideon, will free his people of the enemy. Gideon finds it hard to believe. Who is he? And where is the army? There is no Hebrew army. And yet, the angel assures him that it will come to pass. Meanwhile, the situation in the land is getting worse by the day. The enemy is on the move.
Midianite army crossed the border last night. We must stop them.
Stop the Midianite army? Who can do that?
You can, Gideon, can't you?
God will give you all you need, and you will defeat the Midianites. Where are they now?
They're in the valley of Jezreel. They came last night. I left at first light.
Look, call up all the men you can find. We'll declare war on those Midianites, and by God's grace, we'll beat them.
Yes.
What's going on?
I don't know.
Who's that?
Oh, you better go check it out.
Come on.
The Midianites have come with an army. They're getting ready to attack. But we're going to fight back. We need every Hebrew man we can find to bring as many weapons as they can. I want you to go into every village, every farm, north, south, east, west. We'll gather at the spring of Harod. And as soon as we're ready, we'll fight.
Mm-hmm.
Right, let's all go to the Spring of Harald.
Harald, Spring of Harald.
You know what I meant.
Should we ask Raphael first?
No, don't ask Raphael. He wouldn't let us.
I think as long as Daniel is here, we should stay here too.
You think so?
Gideon has become a local hero after fighting off a Midianite attack on his village a couple of years ago. He's become well known as a good fighter and someone with special powers from God. The people know that with God's help and Gideon as their leader, they can overcome the Midianite oppression. And one day they will.
Gideon, where are you going?
I'm going to spy on the Midianites.
I thought your brother was going to do that.
I need to see them for myself first.
Be careful, son.
Now what?
Let's follow them. Come on, let's get the bikes.
We better stay here. They'll be back.
You wanted to go with Daniel. He's going that way.
They go much too fast. We get lost.
Of course not. We've got the map.
Right. So who's coming with me? Annika? Jessica? And Iron? Oh, come on. We want to see the Midianite army, don't we?
The Midianites have brought their entire army into Canaan. They want to take the whole country. When Gideon sees the army camp, he is speechless.
Look at them.
How can we ever defeat an army like that?
I think we should find a place to stay the night.
This'll do. We can stay here for the night.
This place is disgusting.
I'm starving.
Let's go and fish.
Fish?
Yeah, come on.
Even if every Hebrew man came, we'd still be overwhelmed.
When the angel appeared to you, he said he'd give you victory, didn't he?
Yeah, but that was years ago.
It doesn't matter. A promise is a promise.
But did he mean victory this time?
I don't know. He said over the Midianites. If only the angel would speak to me again.
How about you ask God for a sign?
A sign?
Gideon is asking God to put dew on the sheepskin by morning, just like the grass is always wet in the morning. But as a sign that God hasn't forgotten his promise, Gideon is asking him to keep the grass dry overnight.
Not bad, is it?
It's disgusting. I hope it's not poisonous. Wow. And the grass is dry.
Dry as a bone.
There is your answer, Gideon. Victory.
Hey, guys, wake up. Annika, Richard, somebody's coming.
Ah, only joking. Oh. Okay, let's go. Let's go.
Before, haven't I?
We helped you get rid of the Baal Asherah pole.
Of course. You came for Joshua.
No, we came to help you.
We better be on our way.
Well, thank you. Both of you.
Who's this?
An assassin, Joshua. Go and get some rope. Where are you from?
Tell him! Midian!
Joshua, tie him up. When's the attack? When is it?
In a few days.
How many?
Five.
Gideon, do you need any help?
Yes, take this man away for me. 5 days to prepare. It's too little time. Am I supposed to turn a bunch of farmers into soldiers in just 5 days?
We'd better get out of here, Gideon. There could be more spies around, and they want to kill us.
You go with the cart, I'll follow.
You're coming straight away, aren't you, Gideon? We need you.
I know.
I don't know how, but somehow or other you'll do it, won't you?
Do what?
Give us the victory, of course. What else? See you there. Come on!
Give us victory. How am I going to do that?
It's not just you, Gideon. God will do it with us. He promised you. Didn't he? Worried. It's not safe here, Gideon.
Maybe the sheepskin got wet from water that was already on the ground. Maybe there was a puddle underneath or something.
You don't believe it was a sign from God, do you?
Joshua, I'm leading hundreds of men into a war against a powerful enemy. Many of our men will die. That's families losing their husbands, their fathers, their sons.
Well, do it again.
What?
Put the sheepskin on the grass again.
Why?
Ask God to keep the skin dry this time and to have the grass wet. Soaking wet.
Yes.
But do it at the army camp. Jeff is expecting us. It's time to go.
No, we have to do it here first. I need to be absolutely sure that God will give us a miracle.
So, while your army does a head-on attack, mine will surprise them from behind. Between us, we'll slaughter them.
What if this Hebrew Gideon has some secret plan?
Like what? He doesn't have a chance. If we start the attack mid-morning, it'll all be over by the afternoon.
Your Majesty, we found these young people spying on us.
Spying? So why are they still alive?
They may have information about the Hebrew defense, Your Majesty.
I doubt it. So, where are you from, you two? Lost your tongue? Right, take them out. Cut their throats.
No, no, don't kill us. We'll tell you everything.
Wait.
We're from the city of... The town of...
From the village of Opa, where Gideon lives.
Hebrews?
You don't look like Hebrews.
I'll prove it to you. I'll show you where the village is on the map.
Very well. Those men you sent to kill that Gideon, what happened? Is he dead?
No news yet, but the Hebrews are pulling a large army. We say we'd attack in 5 days. I don't think we should wait that long.
No, let's attack in 4 before they have a chance to get a full army together.
Let's not wait 4 days. Who knows what this Gideon plans to do, if he's still alive, of course. Mm. What's the soonest we can attack?
The day after tomorrow. We'll demolish them, kill them all. Well? Yes, that's Orpah. All right, go back to your friend. Take them down to the kitchen. They can peel potatoes.
You're very kind to them.
You think so? They're dead anyway. If not today, then tomorrow.
My God, what are we to do?
Jeff! Where is Gideon?
He's on his way.
Should be here any minute now.
When's the battle? Tomorrow?
Tomorrow? No, we couldn't, could we? We need at least a few days to get ready.
They say the Midianites have horse guards and sword fighters.
They have. But Gideon will have a plan. We'll mount a surprise attack. Send them all running. Just get some sleep, yeah?
But what if they attack us before we're ready?
Just get some rest.
Absolutely dry, Gideon.
And feel the ground, it couldn't be any wetter than this. He's giving us victory, Joshua. Now I believe it.
Yes! But what if they attack tomorrow?
No, the spy said 5 days and we have 4 more days to prepare and we're going to need them.
Gideon, I think they'll attack tomorrow.
Well, how do you know?
I just know. Somehow.
I'm going back to the farm. They might have captured him. I've got to try to find him.
Please don't. He'll come. He's just working things out.
Sonia, he might be dead.
No, Jeff. Have faith.
But...
Please, stay.
You need time to get ready. I know. But you'll never win in a straight clash. How do you think you can beat them?
God may send a storm or an earthquake, a sickness even. I don't know, anything could happen. We may not even have to go to war.
Perhaps not. Or you might ask us to do a surprise attack at night and take them when they're least expecting it.
How could we attack them at night? We wouldn't even see what we're doing. And besides, it would be wrong to attack them while they're asleep.
But we're defending our lives. And you're in charge. This is war. And if we lose, we die.
That's not gonna happen, Joshua. Now, come on, let's go.
Richard, where are the others?
They're in trouble.
Where are you going?
To the Hebrew camp. The battle is on.
Here, have a drink. We better go.
None of your tricks, young man, or I'll chop your head off.
Would you like some help with the cabbages?
Get on with it, young lady. What's that? Here with it. Come on. Get on with it, you lazy kids.
You've wasted 2 whole days, and now you tell me you don't know? I'd have thought by now you'd have a plan. All these men here...
All these men are here because they believe they can win. Now, will you do the same, Jeff?
These men trust you.
Trust in God. He has given us his promise. We will have victory.
The Midianite army is 4 times bigger than ours. Look, they're stationed here, 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 and here. Maybe we should... attack them at dawn. Surprise them when they're least expecting it.
Jeff, we have to hear from God first.
And when will that be? Next week? Next month?
God has given us a promise. We know that for sure. He won't let us down.
Well, when you do hear, make sure you let me know. Huh? In the meantime, let's make some plans of our own.
Are you taking charge now, Jeff?
No. You're the leader. But if God doesn't speak, then what?
Trust me. He will.
How many young men do we have?
Young enough and fit enough to climb up these hills in full gear.
Gideon, listen to my voice. Too many men have come here to be in your army. If I give you victory, which I will, the people will boast that they have saved themselves. That's not how I want it. Send all those who are afraid back home.
But that's most of them.
The angel of the Lord has told me to send all the men who are afraid back home.
What? But we'd have no army left. God wouldn't do that. He couldn't say it.
Gideon! Gideon! I'm looking for Gideon.
Here I am.
I have a word from God for you. I think it's important that you hear it straight away.
Speak.
God's word for you is that you send home every man who is fearful of the enemy. Obey God, and you will have victory.
The men that are frightened have now gone home, and that is most of them. The small army of farmers that is left will be completely outnumbered by the enemy forces. And then, just as calm has settled on the camp, Gideon receives another message from heaven. The angel tells him to take his men to the river and let them drink. Gideon is told that whoever carefully scoops the water up from the river should go home. Only the ones that drink straight from the water can stay. Gideon is left with, well, you couldn't call it an army, just a small group of men.
How's it going? Get on with it.
Hey, go on, go on. Get him down. Yay!
Honestly think that God would forget about us.
It'll take a miracle to come out of this alive.
You're outnumbered 100-1. Imagine being attacked by 100 men.
But you're looking at it the wrong way.
You can't win, not with just a handful of men.
What's happening?
I'm going home. You want to come?
No, I'm staying.
What about you, Joshua? You want to come?
Of course not. We're in it together.
I'm sorry, Gideon.
Jeff!
Time to rest. Tomorrow will be the day.
They know too much! Find them and kill them! Up there!
Over there!
Over there!
That night, the camp is very quiet, with so few men left. It's not just quiet. The atmosphere is very still. No one moves, no one speaks. There's no wind, no sound from birds or animals. Even the river seems to hold its water. Nature is holding its breath. Gideon's men know that very soon now, they'll either have victory over the Midianites or they'll be dead. No one can help them now. Except God himself. Gideon, listen to my voice. Wake your men and attack in an hour. Take the enemy by surprise. Now, if you still have any doubt that I'll give you victory, go into the enemy camp, just the two of you. I have a surprise for you there.
Wake the men immediately. We'll attack in an hour.
So Gideon and his helper sneak into the enemy camp, not quite knowing what to expect. They crawl past lots of tents, still looking for a clue. Then it happens.
I had this terrible dream. A huge loaf, as big as a horse. It came rolling down the hill, knocked our tent flat. It crushed us to death.
You can only hope that this is not about Gideon, the warrior. They say that his God has made him invincible.
Never realized they'd been sent running by a tiny little army. The news of Gideon's victory spreads quickly throughout the country, and the Hebrews know that God has performed a miracle. The friendship with the God of Moses is restored. The people are free again and safe. And Gideon will always be remembered for his bravery. He was willing to listen to the voice of the angel.
Although our story of Gideon has come to an end, the old book gives us a few more interesting details. Gideon became famous and very prosperous and could afford many wives. And as a result, he had 70 sons. I imagine a family of at least 100 children. Gideon lived a long and happy life. You can imagine. And he was the leader of the Hebrews for over 40 years. And during all that time, there was peace and prosperity in the land. But here it comes. Soon after Gideon dies, the people forget about the God of Moses and begin to build Baal altars for idol worship. So as the people turn away from their God, God turns away from his people. And soon enough, there's trouble in the land. The situation goes from bad to worse, year in, year out. And then eventually, the people begin to remember their God again and call out for help. And so the story starts all over again.
I'll never ever leave you. I am your God. I will never leave you nor forsake you. I will always be your guide.